Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I'm a little bit anxious that I'm going to do a good job on today's demo because this is one of those apps that I think if you really give it its due, it might be life-changing for you. But it's a little bit complex to understand. And a lot of people say, oh, it's just another thing, when really it's another thing that eliminates a whole bunch of just another things. The app that we're going to be talking about today is Slack, and I'm just going to give you a quick background of why it's so relevant for me. My team is growing. I've got a virtual team now of three people in addition to myself, spread all over the world, and as my team has grown, I found that I'm getting stretched to my limit communication-wise because each one of my team members likes to use a different tool for communications. One of them loves to communicate with me in Facebook Messenger. Another loves to communicate with me in Skype Messenger, the instant messaging side of Skype. One uses email. Actually, they all use email fairly well. But the bottom line was that I was getting stretched into all of these different places and beginning to lose cycles, beginning to lose the amount of time to find something. And I was worrying that I was going to miss something important because I wasn't looking in the right place for something that was relevant. Along at the perfect time comes Slack in my life. It's been around for a little while, and teams are really discovering that it works for them. It's this new phenomenon of a different type of information overload, which I'm calling, for lack of better terms, fractured communications. The fact we're using all of these different channels to communicate with, and we can get lost between the channels, information can get lost, and things can get off the rails. Slack gives us a unified communication interface that allows us to all work in the same space, and they make it worthwhile because they give us a whole bunch of benefits if we commit to communicating in Slack itself. You want to have a quick look? I think you'd stick around because we're looking at Slack today on Dotto Tech. I have to apologize for the bit of a long intro, but Slack is a tool that takes a little bit of time to get your head around. Now, I mentioned to you the reason that I really like Slack and why Slack is working so well for me is it allows me to bring together all of the different, it allows me to bring into one place all of the people who I need to communicate with on my team and flow all of our communications into the one space. There's a mobile app, which I'll show you in just a few moments, but right now I'm in the desktop app. There's also a web-based app that you can use, so Slack allows you to access your account from any tool that you happen to be on, be it your smartphone, your computer, or even using web access from somebody else's system. Now, Slack divides itself into kind of two broad areas. The first area is your teams. Now, teams can be companies, they can be departments, or they can be project-based. The second thing we have are the channels. Channels allow us to be more granular with information. So we might have a marketing channel for our company. Within that marketing, we might have an events channel, we might have a marketing team in our company. We might have an events channel, a promotions channel, channel set at that level, or it could be more granular and we could have a channel set for a single event. We're going to social media marketing world. Here's all of the details and here's all of the conversation around that. Into each channel comes all of the different accounts, and the individuals can join into channels, which means they'll be flagged in the conversations in the channels. You can also direct message back and forth and communicate at any point with all of your team members, which is the main way that you're going to be using Slack for the most part, and it works like another instant messaging application at that point. Now, people always ask, well, how is this different than email or other instant messenger? It's different than email because it's very instant and it's very team-based, so your information is not getting lost in a big email, and there isn't as big a kind of a barrier to entry with as far as opening your email, downloading your email, opening it, and the replying. It's much more instant messengery. It's not going to be for everybody. It doesn't replace email completely. It reduces the amount of email you do because most of your external communication with clients and prospecting, those sorts of things are still going to go through email. But with your team should have far fewer emails and you should have no more of those CYA emails where people are copying you back and forth and you've got a huge email nested thread to read through in order to find the relevant information. Slack completely eliminates that productivity vampire. That alone probably makes it worth it for some of you to embrace Slack. But it does more than that. It also gives us one place to store common files. It'll allow us to integrate with tools like Google Drive and Dropbox, but it also has its own file management and file storage system. In the free version, you get up to 5 gigabytes of space per team. So you've got quite a bit of space that you can store files, but you can also integrate other corporate tools or other tools like Dropbox if you choose to. So it's really how you decide to set up your own system. Communication happens just as you'd expect, is you can send information back and forth to people saying, hey, how's it going? All through the Instant Messenger app side, so you can have nice communications going back and forth, all threaded and tagged together. If you're communicating in channels, everybody within that channel will get the notification. And you can also set up private groups. If you just are working on a small little thing, or you want a private management group that's slightly separate, you can set them up as well. So it's very flexible as far as how you set it up. The way that you enroll different team members or enroll people in Slack is you just invite them in. So you send them an invite, they get it by email, and then they sign up, and then they're brought in. The app itself is free, and most of people I know are still using the free version of the app. Where you start to have to pay is when your message archive that you want to be able to search is larger than 10,000 messages, or when you need more than that 5 gigabytes of space per team for storage. So there's a variety of different entry points that you can go into the paid version. But I mentioned that 10,000 message limit. That's one of the real strengths of Slack, the ability to be able to search back on messages at any time. Far faster and far more efficient than finding information in email or anything, except the possible exception in my mind of Evernote. The search is lightning fast, very accurate. So if you decide that it's a tool that you're going to use ongoing in your business, then upgrading to that larger than 10,000 message bucket that you can search becomes very valuable, because then you can search back through your whole historical archive. Now, you don't have to worry. That's not something that you have to make a decision on early on in your Slack career, because it takes you a long time to reach that 10,000 messages. And even if you wait beyond that to decide that you're going to go for the paid tier, you only see the first 10,000 messages, but the others are still stored for you and available for later. They use a fairly deep and good level of encryption as far as security goes, so you're in very good shape as far as all of that. And it's very flexible. You can set it up for multiple teams. I've got it set up for my Dottotech team, for the 4 people that I work with. We also have it set up here to support a course that we're teaching on Slack. I'll put a notification of that in the end of this video, but we're actually using Slack as a delivery mechanism to teach. And we just launched this last week, but we have some 40 or 50 students already taking the course. And each of the modules we set up as a channel. And if you go and look, you see the different media types. Here we've got a video available, which is basically the introduction to the whole course running in YouTube that they can view right within Slack. Isn't that cool? And oh, the integrations go way beyond that. I'm going to have to do another demo showing the video conferencing integrations and how it works with Dropbox and other tools. Evernote, it works. It's got integrations with a large variety of tools. Pretty much, it's kind of like Evernote in the fact that everybody wants to get a piece of Slack, so they're all building their applications with Slack in mind. There's native integration already for tools like Trello, the task and to-do list manager, for Wunderlist, Asana. We're seeing all of them coming down the pipe and finding ways to integrate with this tool to make sure that they take advantage of Slack's communications capabilities. Oh, I promised I would show you the mobile app before we're done. And if I didn't promise you, I should have promised you, because the mobile app is just as good as the desktop app. Here it is. I'm launching it on my smartphone, and they do a good job of kind of working your way through the tools. So here, if I swipe to the left, it brings up all of the different settings. I can switch teams. I can only see one team at a time in the mobile app, but I can switch back and forth between the different teams just that easily. And if I swipe to the left, I've got all of my channels, and I've got all of my teams, and I've got all of those communication tools available to me there as well. So you can see that the mobile app really is identical to the desktop app in form and function. So all of your training and all of your learning on one platform translates across into the other. And of course, it's iOS and Android and everything in between. So it works on pretty much all of the different mobile platforms as well, except BlackBerry. It does work on BlackBerry, sorry. I could spend hours on Slack, and I'm probably going to do a few more demos on Slack coming down the pipe, especially if you let me know in the comments area if you want to know more about Slack, if this is a tool that you like and that you want to know more about. But it's one that I'm really excited about. It's changing how I work, and I can see the benefit on a daily basis. I hope you found this video today to be useful. Now, there's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dottotech. The first is subscribe to this channel. The second, subscribe to our newsletter. And the third is Dottotech is a community-funded site supported through our partners at Patreon. If you want to know about the different perks involved in being a Patreon supporter, I encourage you to drop by our website. And as a completely self-serving note, before we're done, I'm going to put a link in to this page, which is the description of our Slack Made Easy course. If you've decided you like what you see of Slack here and you want to learn more about using it, why not take a look at the course? You can be a member of the group that I was just showing you. We basically use Slack to teach you how to use Slack. It's a $40 investment and you will learn how to use Slack quickly, effectively, and get you in and productive as quickly as possible. So we'll include the link in the description field. That's all the time we have for today's show. I am Steve Dotto. Until next time, have fun storming a castle.